film is not yet rated. In theaters October 10th. Presenting the all-new, sleeker, more powerful Solara. Who can resist?
Friday, your favorite stars making crazy big money, and still you hear how they were unhappy with their paychecks. Now, wait until we show you what they really make on 2020 Friday.
Bachelor Bob and a rose ceremony with a surprising twist. The two-hour season premiere of The Bachelor, ABC tomorrow, 9, 8 central.
I'm the next NYPD Blue.
An IAB officer tells you your career is over, calls you dirty spick, and you just dealt with it?
Objection asked and answered.
Sustained.
You didn't just threaten Captain Fraker, did you? You reached for your gun, right?
I did not.
You were provoked. Your career was on the line.
Your honor, counsel's badgering.
Sustained. He was drunk and he shot me. That's what happened.
Up next, an arrest and a murder mystery. Power problems after tornadoes hit New Jersey. The Yankees try to clinch the division. And why getting a flu shot may be easier this year. Eyewitness News begins right after tonight's $100 million Mega Millions drawing. And that's next.
Across America with Mega Jackpots, it's Mega Millions.
And good evening, everybody. I'm Glenn Burns. It's Tuesday, September the 23rd, and tonight's Mega Millions jackpot is an estimated annuitized $102 million. To win the jackpot, all you have to do is match all five white balls plus the Mega Ball. Our first winning number is 51. Up next, 5, followed by 16. Then we have 49 and 24. Now for the Mega Ball. Here's tonight's Mega Ball winning number. It's 28. Your winning numbers again are 51, 5, 16, 49, 24, and the Mega Ball is 28. If nobody matches all six numbers, Friday's jackpot could be worth $126 million.
This is the news leader, ABC 7 Eyewitness News.
Her death unsolved for years. Now police say they have the man who killed a local teacher. Tonight, wild weather leaving thousands in the dark as tornadoes hit New Jersey. Through skylights and vents, an acrobatic burglar is hitting homes in our area. And it is time to get your shot. A warning about this year's flu season. And good evening to you. I'm Liz Cho.
And I'm Bill Ritter. We begin with that murder mystery. And tonight, cops say they have solved it. A man now charged with the brutal beating and fatal stabbing of a New Jersey school teacher. That attack happened nearly 3 years ago in the Maplewood home of private school teacher Christine Burns. But it was a huge break in the case that led to the arrest. With the story, Jim Dolan. He's in Maplewood for us tonight. Jim?
Bill, the Maplewood police were baffled. It was December 2000, and a school teacher had been brutally raped and murdered in her home, and everyone who knew her had an airtight alibi. And there was this messy business of the DNA. They had solid DNA evidence. It didn't match anyone she knew. Months went by and years went by, and the family thought they might never have an answer, but now they do. A convicted felon gave police a DNA sample while in prison, and he has been charged with Christine Burns' murder. It seems everyone in Maplewood, New Jersey, has hired private security over the last 3 years on quiet, tree-lined streets where you might think crime is something they see on the local news. It is here. So close to home.
I think it was a shock to everybody, and actually we just moved, we were moving, in the process of moving to Maplewood at the time that this happened, so it was really disconcerting to us to hear that, you know, two doors down something like this could happen.
46-year-old Christine Burns was the divorced mother of two young daughters back in December of 2000 when, in her Maplewood home, she was beaten and raped and stabbed until she was dead. For nearly 3 years, police had nothing to go on, and the family was left mourning and waiting.
These were people whose lives were ripped apart by a trauma, and they had to wait a long time for this day to come. And everyone here, especially those who were directly involved in this investigation, are acutely aware of the pain of that family every day as they waited to find out who was responsible.
Douglas Manning of neighboring Irvington, New Jersey, has now been charged with Burns' murder. He was in prison convicted of an unrelated burglary and assault with a knife when he gave authorities a DNA sample. It matched the DNA of Burns' attacker nearly 3 years later.
This was a crime that was not solved quickly. And as time passed by, you know, we felt certain internal pressure, obviously, to bring this matter to justice. It was a rather notoriously reported crime. It was particularly brutal.
In her neighborhood, everyone had a theory about Christine Burns' murder, and most of them involved her family members and friends, but they were all wrong. This, it turns out, was a target of opportunity, a random act, and that thought was hardly comforting in her neighborhood tonight. Reporting live from Maplewood, Jim Dolan, ABC 7, Eyewitness News.
Jim, thank you. Tonight, at least 15,000 people in New Jersey are in the dark after a powerful tornado swept through the state. The twisters hit without warning. High winds snapped utility poles, some of them landing on top of cars. And those without power will most likely have to wait until morning for their electricity to be restored. Central and southern New Jersey were hit the hardest, and there is confirmation of another tornado in Dutchess County. The strong winds caused widespread damage, taking down trees, many landing on homes and making a mess of the roadways. With the very latest now, here's New Jersey reporter Anthony Johnson.
The tornadoes left behind some incredible scenes of devastation. Near Flemington, New Jersey, two barns were blown apart.
Buildings, not much we can do with. They're right. Gone.
Pretty amazing, though, huh?
Oh, yeah. You didn't see the barns down there. They're gone. Picked snowmobiles up and like toys.
Another twister touched down along Ewing's main business corridor. Utility poles snapped in half. Lines were left dangling on the streets, and debris was scattered everywhere. Folks who work in the area had little warning to get out of the way.
It is unreal, like a scene out of a movie. Like I said, when it came down and it just cut its path right through the shop, and people were just screaming.
Less than 5 miles away in Lawrence, the cleanup got underway. But it is amazing to see just how many homes were damaged by fallen trees and branches. Folks say all of this devastation took place in just a matter of minutes, and the damage forced the early closure of school.
We looked out the window and it was like there was just stuff flying by, and our windows were open and they slammed shut, and all of a sudden our principal comes on and says to move to the middle of the room, so it like freaked everyone out.
At dusk, PSE&G crews were preparing to work through the night to get the power back up. This tractor sat in an old storage barn that had been here for 80 to 90 years, that is, until today, when it was ripped apart by the tornado. In Surgeonsville, Anthony Johnson, ABC 7, Eyewitness News.
We have some big sports news tonight, although many...
Starts with Arm & Hammer, like Super Scoop. That's because only Arm & Hammer litters have the odor-absorbing power of Arm & Hammer baking soda, which doesn't just cover up odors, it eliminates them. Arm & Hammer Super Scoop or Long-Lasting Crystal Blend.
So, no matter how many cats you wind up...